Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Mandatory Social Interaction Show. My name is Ben, and I am joined today with my ineffable co-host, Tim.
Hello.
And as is now the new tradition, we are also joined by our respective Twitch chats, either me at Ben underscore Burns or Tim at Insert Coin Theater. Theater. And
theater, not tre.
Theater.
Like the British spelling.
Yeah. And as always, we're gonna spend a little bit of time in Minecraft.
Yeah, we gotta keep building up, man.
Yeah,
and
that, now that we're actually streaming at the same time as we are doing this, I have to like write down the times when we start so I know when we actually stop recording.
We,
so
we started just at, like, shy of 4 minutes.
For you, 3:30.
Well, yeah, 3:30 for me. Ah, dang it.
Yeah, I'm at like 8.5 minutes in already.
Oh yeah, that's right. You started a little earlier than me.
Yeah, because I'm prepared and professional.
Hey, Mavanis. Mavanis joined us in chat.
Nice.
He said he's gonna go sit in the corner because we're recording a podcast. You don't have to do that, man. We're here to discuss and hang out.
Yeah, and we have topics prepped this time. So
yeah, I got some stuff I want to talk about though.
Oh, cool.
First off, I've got a story to share.
Ooh.
So the other day, my dog Ash.
Yep.
Was outside. You want to slaughter some cows?
Yeah, I was going to say we need to start the episode with our traditional massacre.
We need to feed him first. He was outside, and I was cooking. I was making a delicious meal of stovetop
stuffing,
chicken,
oh,
and potatoes, and
you just know, don't the, eat the stovetop stuffing just right out of the box.
Oh!
Did you blow a hole in the wall?
I blew a hole in the side of our mine area because there was a creeper hanging out in there.
Oh, boy.
Wow, that was horrifying. Anyways, so he's doing his thing, barking, being...
I'm going to come down and see what's going on.
Creepers, just watch out for fucking creepers. That's all I can say. They're being jerks. So he was barking towards the house, which is unusual. Whoa, I'm getting some weird feedback from you.
Okay, yeah, there's planes going over the house. Just a second. Ah!
Ben Burns lives at an airport, for those of you who don't know. He's actually a pilot. JK. I don't think
Want it to be like a nice day out. And you know,
it sounds like a beautiful day, which is why there's planes out.
It's a flipping perfect day out, and it's like, oh my god, there's a giant hole in our room.
I don't want to hear what your day is like right now because it is like 9,000 degrees outside here in Florida.
Hi, so. Tim. I can see you through our floor for some reason.
Oh, hi! Did we lose anything up there?
No, for some reason the bed is just hovering, but...
Well, I'm okay with that. It's just the creepers.
There.
I put more lights down so that it shouldn't happen again, but...
Well, I fixed it.
Sorry about that.
Whatever.
Well, anyways, so he was barking towards the house for some reason, and I was like, what the heck is he doing? Like, why would he do that? And it's unusual for him because he's usually barking at the fences on the left side of the road or the right or of the lawn.
Yeah.
Left side of the lawn, whatever. So we were like, why is he barking towards the house? Is there like a raccoon or a possum or something like that that got in the backyard and we need to worry about this? And, turns out that, I go in the back and there's a, probably 12 to 14 inch bearded dragon in the backyard.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So he's all puffed up and he's got his mouth open and he's looking at Ash menacingly because Ash is sitting there barking like, what the heck is this? This thing's awesome looking. I want to play with it. You know? they don't like really breed in the wild because,
they're not native to your area either.
No.
Are they? Yeah.
They're considered an invasive species, I guess, but
oh, wow.
They don't really breed much.
Huh.
So it's not like you don't see them in the wild ever unless somebody gets rid of a pet. So we were like, somebody lost their pet, you know, and we don't know what to do with a freaking like bearded dragon, a freaking massive lizard. Like, what do you do with that? So we're like, okay, well, this is somebody's pet, so we're gonna post about it on Craigslist. We're gonna go around the neighborhood. We caught the guy by throwing a pillowcase on it on top of his head, much like you would do with an alligator. You blind them. Because here in Florida, we have alligators, and you kind of learn how to deal with alligators a little bit in case, you know, the worst happens. isn't that a weird thing? Like, you probably would have no idea what the hell to do with an alligator.
Don't run in a straight line. That's all I know. Or
that
no,
is a myth.
Yeah, alligators, or is it crocodiles that can't turn?
Okay. I think it's crocs.
Yeah,
is what the myth is, and I don't know if it's true about them. But alligators are just fast, no matter what they do. They're just gonna tear you up.
Just punch it in the eyes, then I guess.
They're not sharks. But anyway, so
land sharks.
I threw a pillowcase on its head, and you grab it on its side, and you don't grab it hard. You just pick it up.
Yeah.
And it's was squirming and all this crap, and we pick him up and we put him in a bucket, and we go around the neighborhood and ask if he belongs to anybody. And everyone's like, I don't want to have anything to do with a giant lizard. And I'm like, oh well, he's kind of cool looking, you know. This got to be somebody's. So, I went around and nobody knew anybody who had lizards, right? Hmm. So we bring him home and we keep him overnight, and he's just miserable in a little tiny box. He's a big dude in a little box.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's not humane to keep him in a little box. So we're like, you know what? We did some Google searching, and there was a reptile rescue, and we were like, look, if worse comes to worse, we'll get him a place to stay. If we have to, we'll give him up to the rescue. And if the people that, you know, we post about on Craigslist, if whoever owns him comes and says, oh, my baby, we know we're definitely going to give him back.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, for now, we've adopted a bearded dragon.
Oh, my God. That's pretty
so
cool.
Yeah, so we... Yeah, it's kind of cool. He's a cool guy. We went and picked up a tank on the cheap, and we've been doing a ton of research on how to keep bearded dragons happy and what they eat and stuff, and we're trying. He's a picky eater, which is weird because he's a huge lizard.
Yeah,
he's a huge lizard, but like you'd think he would, you know, not be picky, but he's picky, and so we're trying to figure out what he likes. But we've had him for a couple of days now, and he has a really cool vivarium with sand in it and everything. Like he loves it, and it's got like the heating lamp, and he's digging it, man.
That's cool.
He's loving life. So it's better than him getting eaten by like a hawk or an eagle. So
yeah, I guess that would be a threat, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we have some around here. So Formal says crocs and alligators are agile, and she says beardies are a-holes and can be super picky. So yeah, I don't know much about bearded dragons, but I'm learning, and today I learned they can be picky bastards. So
what do they eat?
They eat what are called superworms, which are these like giant bitey worms that can bite humans.
Oh,
if you
nice.
Don't want to handle them, use tongs to grab them out of their little containers. And they eat crickets, they eat locusts, they eat mealworms, silkworms, they eat a lot of stuff. And then they eat, as they get older, they're supposed to transition to about 80% to 90% vegetables. And so they'll eat kale and lettuce and carrots and, you know, just vegetable stuff. So
interesting.
We're having trouble getting him to eat his veggies, much like getting a child to eat their vegetables.
Or you.
But yeah, it's like we spend about an hour and a half every day trying to figure out what kind of veggies he likes, and he doesn't like any of them so far. Like we've tried blueberries and strawberries and everything, and he's just like, nope, I don't want nothing. So, but yeah, so we named him Tiberius. I call him Tiberius because the pun is too strong and too easy to go for. And hello to Attack Burger in my chat. What up, Burger? How you doing,
Burgie?
Buddy?
Burgie! How you doing, man?
Superworm's only weakness is to kryptonites.
Or bearded dragons.
It's their weakness for eating. Like, they can actually get obese off of superworms. So yeah, that was my excitement for the week. That was my thing, and he's cool looking. Like he's a cool guy. So I'm really excited to have him as part of our little family.
Yeah, even if it might be temporary, that's still awesome.
Yeah, yeah, and you know if oh my God, there's a creeper wandering around near our books and stuff in our
what the game. Hell?
Where are they coming from?
I don't know. I thought that the torches and stuff kind of push them away.
It's supposed to keep them from spawning. We might not have enough torches.
Well, add more then, I guess.
Yeah, I'll go around and add more torches. I'm trying to figure out where the hell they're spawning. I don't know.
Well, it might be inside the spa. I know that there were some guys spawning in there before, but I thought we kind of took care of that, so I don't know.
Well, I'm going to put some more lights just in case. I can never be too certain, you know? Okay.
So what else is new with you this week?
Nothing too much. Formal says, never feed lettuce, not enough nutrients, kale, or collard greens. He may just be stressed out, which is why he isn't eating. And
yeah,
that's kind of
that was one thing I was going to say, too, where, you know, a huge change in environment like that might just be a trigger for a pet for them to just kind of stress out and not do anything.
Yeah, he's calmed down a lot, though. Like, he used to, like, every time we come in to, like, pet him or pick him up, he'd puff up and get all upset. Now he actually doesn't care. He knows us now, so he's calming down, which is a good thing.
That's
really cool. Yeah, it's awesome. He actually seems pretty smart, too, because, like, he knows where his food comes from already. Like, we fed him once from the tube that has the superworms in it.
Yeah.
And you can't see them through the thing, but he goes over there and is, like, waiting by it every time we put him on the table now.
Oh, boy.
It's like, I want this. Give me. Like, you're going to be fat. No. Bad. Shame. Calm down. All right? We don't want an obese lizard.
You can't fat shame him. You can't body shame him. He's your pet.
I can.
He's your family.
Got to keep his lizardlish figure.
I finally made it to the top.
I'm a lizard shitlord. Oh, did you finally make it to the top?
Yep, there's a path all the way up. You do you even have an idea how much like work has gone into this?
You've been working on it for like a month and a half.
Yeah.
In terms of our show, so
yeah, and this is
I have an idea.
It's just getting to the top. It's not like making it look fancy or anything. It's just getting there. So
you are a sick man, Ben Burns.
What else do you do in Minecraft?
True, just build monuments and weird shit.
Yeah, you just make giant dick statues, I guess. But this seems more productive.
You're probably right.
I'm going to put a portal up here, and that way...
It also says hashtag all lizards are beautiful.
I was going to make a portal up here so guys just spawned up here and nobody could get to them. It's perfect. I don't have enough
brilliant.
Obsidian.
It's foolproof.
I need way more foolproof. Obsidian. I thought, for some reason, I thought 8 was enough, which it definitely is not.
So I wanted to pick your brain about something, Ben.
Oh, yeah, what's up?
Something that I've been thinking about since it's almost that time of year again.
Okay.
So, normally, there's a charity event that happens every year. You may have heard of it. I know you've heard of it because you attended our rendition of it earlier. I think it was earlier this year. Was it the beginning of this year? Extra Life.
Yeah. I think you did that last year.
Was that last
maybe
year?
Maybe you did it like in...
It was end of the year.
Yeah.
It was with George.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
So, yeah, it was at the very end of December. And, so that's coming up again. And I kind of wanted to ask you if you would be interested in doing Extra Life.
Yeah.
This, not this year, because I think because I did it at the beginning of the year, I still count as having done Extra Life 2016, even though the main event doesn't happen until November. Omega Creeper, thank you for that follow on Beam. Appreciate you, man. But when it comes, there's the sound effect. I just had a sound effect where it's like, here comes a new challenger.
Oh boy,
because it's still play in the background. I want to do Extra Life, but I don't want to do 24 hours straight.
What are you talking about? That turned out so great.
Oh my god, the last like 8 hour push was. Hell,
yeah.
I can't even come up with another way of saying it was honestly probably the most painful time that I'm not in like terms of pain, but like in terms of like sheer exhaustion levels, it was the most exhausted I've ever felt. And I don't ever want to repeat that. Thinking would be that we could somehow split it up.
Yeah.
Right? So my thought process was that we would... Wow, there's a spider in here. My thought process was that we would take an 8 hour break in the middle somewhere. So like we would start out at the same time, both streaming. And this is just my thought. This is rough.
Oh, yeah.
This doesn't have to be the final product. So just spitballing ideas. But the thought is that... Like we would start out at the same time. We would do some stuff like remember when we had the Unreal tournament?
Yep, I was just going to mention that sounds exactly kind of like the same wheelhouse.
Yeah, I was thinking that we could both stream at the same time for the quote unquote 24 hours or whatever. However, we would have crossover stuff where we would do a different tournament of some kind where, again, instead of just picking whatever charity we would go with, we would just do it all for Extra Life at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
My thinking was that we would do a tournament of some kind, and we would challenge the Game Grazers and Shaka Panda and stuff to join us in that, and I would see if maybe George would want to come out of retirement.
Mm, that'd be cool.
And thank you for the follow on Twitch, Omega Creeper. Appreciate that. On both? Is that on both? I think it was on both. Cool. Thank you.
You're making a little hidey hole over here. What's going on?
What's up?
Oh, you. Is this your like makings down here with the diamond chest piece and stuff? Like there's a
Yeah, that's my set of armor. I wanted to make sure it was separate so it didn't vanish.
Like, that's okay.
I tend to put things in boxes and forget where they went.
No, it's cool.
I won't lose it if I put it down there.
So. I was actually trying to remember how you repaired an item, and it looks
do it. All the anvils are down there, so yeah. So feel free to use the anvils.
So I just need
I
to
set
make
it up so we can share it.
I need to make another one, and then I just mash them together, or. Is that how you make? Is that how you repair again?
Yeah, you put like I think for a sword you put diamonds. I want to say, on the anvil with it, and then you can repair your sword.
No, I'm just talking about my pick.
The same thing with your pick. You put if it's a diamond pickaxe, you put diamonds.
Okay, I'll see if that works.
Yeah.
You can put my pickaxe here. Put a diamond here. Enchantment or enhancement or enchantment cost one. I don't know what enchantment cost means.
I think it takes an enchantment level from it, but I'm not sure. I think it takes one enchantment level from one of your enchants on it.
Doesn't seem like it, but...
It didn't seem like it took it from mine either, so I don't know exactly what it means. So, I don't know. I'm kind of mentally drifting a little bit today. I'm having a kind of a mental rough day because it was a long freaking day, and I've got a long day tomorrow. But anyway, so
that's cool.
Extra Life. So would you be interested? Like, I was thinking that we could do a tournament. We could do MSIS recordings.
Oh, yeah.
Do a couple MSIS episodes.
Just record like a backlog of a month or two. That sounds great.
If that, we could even just do a week or two
or
whatever, whatever we want to do. And then we could do some co-op games. And I was thinking then we could like have a period where like you go to bed and you get like 6 or 8 hours of sleep or whatever. And then you come back and then I go to bed and get like 6 or 8 hours of sleep. And then we're happy and not dead.
Yeah.
Am I a genius or what? And that way we're still streaming. It's still a 24-hour stream, but it's duoed.
Yeah, no, I would totally be down with that. I mean, obviously, I have to take into consideration schedules and other events going on, but we can definitely plan something like that.
Well, the best part about Extra Life is you can do it anytime you want. They just have a day that they set out in November for the bulk of it, but... The way that I look at it is if we can, if we just pick a day, then we do it, you know, we do our thing. So, that's kind of my hope is that we could do that. And I think it would be a blast and we can get some of our tournament buddies back involved. Like I can try to pull Furball in again and stuff like that. We can make an event out of it, and we can kick 24 hours in the butt and not be exhausted. Oh God! Oh,
where are you?
Right underground, and I got ambushed by more. What is with the creepers today? It's like creeper madness.
Where underground?
But yeah. Right down the stairs, actually.
Oh. But your name's not showing up on this thing. Oh, there you are.
Hi. Okay, I got ambushed down there, but they have exploded since. So the idea is that we would have a ton of stuff to do. We wouldn't get exhausted, and everybody wins because we raised some sweet, sweet charity moolah.
Yeah, Yeah, I'd totally be down for that. That sounds like a lot of fun. I watched a lot of your stream last time, and I could tell how exhausting it was. but
it's tough. Oops. It's very, very tough. And the way that a lot of the companies do it, like I always bring them up, but they are my favorite example for a lot of the content that is
created, guess,
that I consume.
Rooster Teeth.
Yes. The way they do it is they have their staff come on for like intervals, like 4 to 6 hour intervals, sometimes 8. So they usually only have one person who stays the full 24 hours, and I don't think they have to stay the full 24 hours per their rules, but he does anyways because he's a masochist. So my thinking was that that we could split it up and we would be able to stomach it a little bit better. And then that way I don't have to like consume like 12 Red Bulls in a 3 hour period and feel like barf. I'm going to die.
Yeah, no thanks.
Yeah, like I felt like I was going to die at the end of it. My heart was racing and I was having trouble breathing right and stuff. God. I was like, this is bad. It was bad. It was a rough, rough time. So, as fun as it was, I think that if we can break it up, it'll be a much better experience.
No, and I had a lot of fun playing Unreal Tournament with you guys before, and I would love to do that again with like Quake or something else. Like, I love
The new Doom's out, and you have that as well. So
I do.
That could be an option as well.
I guess I never really played the multiplayer for that.
It's pretty good. It's very Quake-esque.
But I know I'm good at Quake, or at least I was.
You'll probably be good at Doom. It's very, very similar. It's not very different, and it's shinier.
That's true. Shinier is pretty good sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah, so I think it'll be fun. We can talk about those details, but I think Doom or Quake or something like that would be fun rather than doing Unreal Tournament again.
Oh yeah, and Unreal Tournament was fun, but it's good to switch it up.
Oh yeah, definitely. So I think it'll be a good experience overall, and we can join forces as communities. And raise some funds for Extra Life, I think that would be good.
And I like Extra Life anyway.
Yeah, they're a good charity. They do a lot of good work, so.
I do that in Child's Play, like, every year.
Yeah, Child's Play is good, too. The Extra Life comes out, is coming up in November. I don't like to do it on the Extra Life Day just because it is very crowded.
And, yeah, I'm sure.
There's just so many people that do it. I mean, it's humongous, gargantuan even, and in terms of best value for best bang for our buck or time would be to do it in like January, February after the holidays when people's bank accounts are recovering from Christmas time and all that stuff. So.
Well, that and everybody's stuck indoors in January anyway, like. It's like post holiday depression. I've heard it.
Like, unless you're in Florida, then it's like 90 degrees.
Yeah, well, yeah, there's that. I've heard people call it the long 90 because there's like no holidays. There's no nothing. It's just a bunch of days where the weather's generally pretty crappy.
Yep. Yep.
Why am I using an axe to try to get obsidian?
I don't know. That's a good question. And Soph says that he'll be there to shit talk me the whole time. Thanks, buddy.
Well, that's all.
Appreciate
you need
that, man. Well, that it helped a little bit. It did. It keeps you going.
Oh yeah,
it was a good time. We had a really good time with it, so I'm excited. I think there's a lot of good stuff that we can do. Like, there's a lot of really fun co-op games that we can play.
Yeah, and we have so many like Steam keys. We can do giveaways and all that crap too. So
yep. That's what I was thinking. Do some fun stuff. Do some giveaways. One thing that's really popular for people to do is there's a wheel, and if they donate a certain amount, then the wheel gets spun, and it has like ridiculous things on it.
Oh, gotcha.
Like, chugging energy drinks, ketchup, or something like that.
No.
You know, ridiculous. Yeah, chugging ketchup. God no. So yeah. So
that'd
be fun. It's pretty cool. There's some cool ideas that I've got that might be a good time to take upon ourselves and implement. So
yeah, we'll talk about it. And we'll try to figure out who else would be down to join us for that. But
yeah.
I'm more than happy to like work with you and kind of host and manage the event too, because I know it's going to be a lot of a lot of like wrangling.
It'll be
people.
A lot of minutiae. Yeah. It'll be a lot of minutiae involved. So
it's always a lot of wrangling people.
Yeah. But yeah. So I wanted to ask, and I'm glad that you are amenable to it because I think it'll be a lot of fun. Be a good time.
It's always a good time.
You have to be stuck with me for 24 hours. Bum, oh, bum, no. Bum.
That's so scary. That's fine. I don't know. I like hanging out with you. I like playing games. I just don't have like an excuse to do it most times.
Well, and Extra Life's a good time to do it.
Yeah. And I mean, that's what I've said before, where it's like I use these like streams as an excuse to play games because it feels like I'm doing something productive, even though I'm just playing games. But
yep.
You know, it's something.
It is something.
A lot
it
of
exists.
Chickens. It's a whole There's lot like, of
and they are extremely loud. God.
Not for long.
Bark, 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 bark. Bark, 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 bark.
Is that, does That's that do it funny. For you?
All I hear is bark. God, that's funny.
It's some sweet experience.
Sounds brutal, though. It sounds awful. Oh, man.
Okay, well, there's less chickens now.
Murderer.
There we go.
Oh, man.
That's better.
All right, what are we doing here? What else?
Oh, I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, I have a potato. I can go plant the potato.
Where'd you get a potato? Where'd you get a potato?
Off of a zombie carrying it around.
That's weird.
They do that. They're very confused creatures. Oh, God.
Is there more creepers?
Get away from the fence. Get away from the fence. God. There's like 80 creepers out there. Oh. Dang it. I just want to plant a potato. And now I'm getting bum rushed by an angry spider. Out of here.
Yeah.
God dang.
What am I even looking for?
I'm trying to decide what I want to build next. I want to build something. I'm in the mood to build something cool.
Okay.
Hmm.
You don't have a whole lot of flint.
I need to find more sandstone, I think. I have an idea.
Oh. What are you going to make? Or is this like one of those surprise kind of things?
I'm going to start working on something and I will surprise you with it. It'll be easy to tell what it is once I actually get to that point, but got to start on it first. So I'm going to begin work on it.
Okay.
Let's see. You'll just have to wait and see. Let me dump my inventory because I'm going to need all my inventory space for this. Oops, that's not what I wanted.
Yeah, I wish I was a little bit better organized, but here we are.
It happens.
Yeah, there's an Enderman. I'm trying to think of what else happened this week, and it's like it kind of blew by really fast.
It was a quick week, thankfully, because it was a hectic week on my end.
No, it was pretty slow for me, but I just it's just working on so many things. It's hard to keep track of what day it is.
You were a busy busy bee this week. So was I, actually. I got a lot done for my YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got several videos put out, which was really, really nice. And I got them edited and put out. I got three, I think, done during this past week, and I plan on getting a couple more done.
Wow.
So it's I'm pretty pleased with it. And it's I've been putting a lot of work into it, and it's actually kind of paying off already. I'm seeing compared to what it used to be, which was two or three views per video, has now bumped up to like 10-ish per video.
Oh,
and
nice.
That was like almost an instant change when I decided to start trimming down my streams into a more digestible Let's Play format.
Interesting. I should look into doing that with my stuff too. And I know that with the music it's more long form intentionally, but I feel like I might be able to condense those downs into more like the interesting bits.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Like, I should just try it once with one of the 2-hour tracks and be like, okay, so this is kind of the stuff that happened that was actually interesting, and the rest is me just dicking around. But if you want to see every step of the process, then, you know, you can go to the full video. I don't know.
Yep.
It's just much work.
It is a lot of work to do the editing, and it's one of those things that you just get quicker at.
Yeah.
Which you've been doing with your creative exploration.
A little bit, yeah. I mean, I know how to edit. It's just I have to sit there and watch a 2-hour video and not really do much else.
Yeah, it's one of the big... one of the big challenges of video of doing streams is because, like, my big problem was that my streams are like 3-4 hours each, right? Mm-hmm. Sometimes, usually my average for a single player game is about 2 hours per stream. And I do that kind of intentionally because A, it keeps me from getting bored with the game.
Yeah.
And B, it keeps it manageable. And what's really cool is when I do a 2 hour stream, I've got 2-3 weeks worth of videos because I do one, I do a video Monday, one Wednesday, one Friday. So it makes it very easy because you just go in, you trim out the boring parts, like any major story points that don't have anything like super awesome or with reactions or anything in them, like just kind of boring story stuff. And you cut out like all the inconsequential chat, like if I'm sitting there chatting with, or if I'm talking with my chat and I don't have any context on the screen or don't read the chat, I just usually cut that out because it makes a lot more sense for the video. And I can usually cut it down to 15-20 minutes. And if it goes longer than that, I put a hard stop at a certain point that seems really good to stop at.
Mm-hmm.
And then I put the rest in another episode and I do another episode. So you can get like 3-4 episodes out of a single stream, which is really, really nice, because it makes content easy to keep coming because you're not necessarily got boring content, but you're condensing your streams down into the parts that you think matter. And it really makes a huge difference in the length and quality of the stream.
Yeah, I can imagine.
It's been really good so far. Like, I wouldn't say my stuff is like master level work or anything, but I'm like starting to put in edits and add text and titles and like do zoom ins and stuff like that on important bits. You know, where prudent, and it's so far it's pretty cool.
Well, and that's really the fun stuff too.
Yeah.
Like that's when you can actually be creative with the process of editing videos, and I think that that's what it makes me like appeals to me for that whole process is that I can kind of mess around, I can play the editor role, and which is like a completely different, you know, person really,
right?
Because you can play the editor and then you can kind of play off of yourself in a lot of ways, and
yes. And one of the things that was hardest for me to get over was listening to me and just like trying to get like over the fact that, man, I was just like I'm a dork, I'm this, I'm that, and like I got to a point where I'm like, I gotta own it because it's me, it's not gonna change and I don't want it to change. I'm happy with who I am and how I present myself. I just come across as a huge dork to myself sometimes, which is weird. So it's hard to swallow the pill of yourself.
If that
makes sense. So like I've been doing a lot of work on that, and so I start doing my editing, and then I'll like find a part that's really funny. Like Furball says it happens to us all, and I was gonna mention that. I think you did like a creative exploration on something about that, like getting over that that initial like dealing with yourself, like, if that makes sense. Like that's the big challenge, is just like understanding you.
Yeah, I don't know if I talked about it, but that would definitely be a good topic to talk about because it's very, very prevalent. Just because you're so critical on about yourself.
Yes. And it's getting over that initial criticality, and being like, well, I might see myself as bad, but I'm hard on myself just because of the fact that it's me.
Yeah.
And I expect better from myself, whether I should or not, whether that's healthy or not, it doesn't matter. You know, it's like, you got to get over that. And so, I've been getting over that pretty much more rapidly than I thought I would.
Yeah.
And, so going into editing, it's much more easy for me to pull out a part where I do something stupid or goofy or funny or say something, you know, in my traditional, my trademark cheesy style. And that's what I end up doing. As I'm like, well, this might be funny. You know, it's not funny to me, but, you know, I thought it was funny in the moment, so I'm going to keep it there.
Yeah.
If I like laugh at something, or if I find something silly, or if I scream at something because it's like either frustrating or shocks me or startles me or whatever, that stays in. And,
yeah.
It's getting much easier for me to, oh God, thank you, creeper, you fucking ass. Pardon my language. Dang, I'm so sick of these creepers. They're such bullies.
Yeah, well, and that's the other thing where it's very easy to dismiss your own work. I know that with the 2 hour track challenge stuff, like half the time I'm done with a song, I feel like, oh, this song was okay. But then I get lots and lots of comments from people who are just like, this is my favorite song yet and stuff. And it's like, I thought this song was kind of crappy, but okay. So it's just like, I mean, everybody says it, but you're your own worst critic. Like,
yes,
it's but it's so easy.
Not necessarily a bad thing.
Either, no, it's though. Not.
Oops, my display driver just crashed for a second there. But yeah, it's one of those things where, like being your own critic, own worst critic is not necessarily like a negative. Like,
no.
It's good to be harsh on yourself just so you're not to the point where it's self-destructive.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's good to push yourself beyond and say, I can do better than that, and mm-hmm. just keep pushing. It's not okay to say, this is garbage, I'm going to throw this out, because you can't do that, because then you'll never have any content ever.
Yeah, pretty much.
So,
And it not only keeps you honest with what you're making, but it also, like you said, it makes you better overall. It's just, you have to learn to listen to that voice and not just be like, well, I think it sounds bad, so it must be bad. Like, you have to kind of push through that and learn to live with the awkwardness of having the stuff that existed in your mind now exist out in reality. Not to get super hippie about it, but, like, that's kind of how it
is. Well, Furball brings up a good point. He says, you're genetically predisposed to dislike your own voice. Disliking something about yourself is one of the first big barriers of self-editing.
Yep.
Exactly. That's exactly right. It's just one of those things that I'm getting over quickly, and I'm happy I am, because it makes it much easier for me to edit my content and make my videos even better. And that's what I'm excited about, is like, rather than focusing on the quality of my voice or the quality of my or the things that I say, I'm focusing more on where I can plug in edits and cool effects and things like that.
Yeah.
And I'll get to a point where I'm good, really good with it and quick, because I'm learning the ins and outs of Premiere as well, which is kind of a big deal as well.
Oh yeah.
Premiere's a tough application to learn. There's so many little nuances with it.
Oh yeah, I haven't used it in a long time, but if it's like any other Adobe product, it's something that takes a long time.
I've started building a back catalog of like crazy or funny moments that have happened in my Let's Play videos.
Uh-huh.
Because my format is that every episode I start with a clip from the video that they're going to watch.
Yep.
Of, you know, like an extremely funny part or a ridiculous part or something over the top that happens. And that's how I'm building my kind of back library of these things, and I'm going to make a really cool YouTube channel intro.
Oh, nice.
Of all that stuff, yeah, using those clips.
That's good.
Once
idea.
I get a bigger catalog going, creepers.
You okay?
I just leveled that out.
We could be so wusses and play in peaceful mode.
No, might as well go creative at that point.
Yeah,
do it the hard way. I want this to be
saying.
A monument to man.
You know, if you want to be a weenie about it, we could. No, it's fine.
Not a weenie. Hey, Chucko, how's it going? It's good to see you, buddy.
So
Luke says, I usually wind up doing absolutely nothing productive until around 5 minutes before it's due, and I no longer give a F about not sounding like an idiot. Dang it! Creepers!
Well, that was Soph that said it?
Yeah.
That's actually a really good point, and something that I found out recently, and, you know, this isn't a 100% like always true kind of thing, but procrastination is often based around like fear of not completing, ironically, or just fear of you know, what the reception of what you're going to make will be. Like, well, I'm afraid I'm going to get a bad grade on this, so I'll just do it later so I have more time to think, or I'll just do it later because I don't want to do it, I don't want to think about it right now. But like, when I heard that, I thought about all the times that I've procrastinated, and a lot of it's because I don't know what people are going to think of the projects that I finish. So I don't know how like grounded in science that is, but I found it very interesting regardless.
Mm.
So
it definitely is. I just find it funny that it's just such a universal thing that like. That people just have real trouble. People by nature have a barrier to self-editing and stuff like that.
It's
very cool thing. Like, not a good thing, but it's a cool thing.
Yeah, brains are pretty neat.
Thing biologically.
Brains really suck sometimes. Brains are pretty cool. Okay.
Soph says, you got me, Tim. I'm secretly all those creepers. I knew it. I knew it. You're bullying me even when you're not bullying me.
Yeah, I don't have many torches up here, so I'm hoping that there aren't many monsters.
Oh. Ran into a cactus. I heard.
And put some torches up here before I lose my mind. Throw this dirt off the cliff. Whoops. The nice thing about working up here is I can just throw everything off the edge that I don't want.
And it'll go away eventually.
And I'll never see it again.
Don't pollute. You polluter.
It's not pollution.
Looting and polluting is not the way. Here's what Captain Planet has to say. The power is yours.
Okay.
No. Do you remember Captain Planet?
Barely.
He's a hero. Gonna take pollution down to zero.
Oh, boy.
No?
Dang it. I had a weird childhood when it came to watching TV. Like, either I watched, like, two different shows and not of any, like, I think it was, like, Garfield and Friends back when I thought that was funny.
You have a great sense of humor, man.
Oh, God. Okay, so are you familiar with Garfield minus Garfield?
Yes, I love Garfield.
Oh, my God, they're
Garfield.
So funny. I don't understand how I loved Garfield so much when I was a kid because, like, I read it now, or at least I look at snippets of it now, and it's like, there's no joke here, Jim Davis. Where were you going with this?
And a lot of them, there is no joke.
Yeah.
And then you read Garfield minus Garfield, and it's like, it all makes sense.
Oh, yeah, they're so good.
It's really an existential crisis of John Arbuckle. He's really imagining the cat. The cat wasn't real.
I'm wondering if I'm going to hit the ceiling.
It's really high, the ceiling is, so...
You don't know how tall this mountain is, dude. The ground is outside of this current chunk. It's not rendered.
Really?
Yeah, like the sea level or whatever you want to call it.
Okay, so the first thing I need to do is I need to get rid of... Well, you know what? I'm gonna put the sign down. That the Captain Planet theme song you linked, Soph? I hope it is. Soph linked some YouTube video in chat.
Oh, boy.
Captain Planet was amazing, man. You just can't knock it.
I
can't believe you never saw Captain Planet. It's
like I might
G.I.
have.
Joe.
I don't know if God. I've seen G.I. Joe either. I might have seen it. I just can't remember. Like, I didn't watch a ton of TV when I was a kid. Which I guess is my fault, not my parents.
Well, before I discovered the internet... Oh, God. Why me?
What'd you break
what
now?
What is this? Oh, I just wish it was daytime. I can't do anything at nighttime. Furball says, oh, yes, I can knock it, Tim.
Yeah. Oops.
And we're gonna run out of time, and I haven't built anything.
We've still got.
Can I set the time to daytime? Can I cheat a little bit?
Oh, you do whatever you want. I don't care.
Okay.
Woohoo! You're the hacker.
Oops. Everybody, catch on fire! Catch on fire!
Yeah, that takes a little bit of time.
I want to start building. I got so many things I want to build.
I'm gonna run out of wood. Oh, I'm going to take fall damage here. Whee!
Okay. Peaceful spider. Oh my gosh. I forgot there are sand zombies now that are immune to the effects of sunlight.
It's hilarious.
It's not hilarious. It's not even funny. It's not okay.
I don't know what I'm doing, but I made this huge hut up here, so that's cool.
Chucko says he predates the internet.
Yep.
Well, I mean, I predate the internet.
I do, really. Too.
I just don't, like, I just grew up and it kind of happened while I was in childhood still.
Yeah, like, I was around when the internet was invented, I guess. But, like, before it became mainstream, like, I just,
I was
Are you an internet hipster?
Yeah, pretty much.
You were on the internet before it was cool.
Oops. I started a fire that I didn't mean to. But yeah, like I was around before the internet. It was a weird time. Or when like cell phones were the size of a brick. And yeah, that's a weird era. But you know,
yeah.
It's weird how fast technology's advanced over the last like 20 years. Like 20 years ago, I mean, I guess that partially like due to like watching Stranger Things recently, where you know,
isn't it set in like the 90s or something?
80s, yeah.
80s.
Yeah. So like they didn't have cell phones back there, and you know, what are you going to do then?
Not call anybody. That's
yeah,
a dang
exactly. Oh, that's a cliff face. I guess I don't want to go that way. So yeah, it's very interesting being like, well, it from a thematic standpoint, it was a very good choice on their part too, because like they could get away with like, oh well, they're kind of in like they're in rural areas, but they're not like they're not in the boonies.
Right.
But you know, if you want to get in touch with somebody, you gotta call them on a rotary phone. Or you gotta like drive over to their house or bike over there, and it's like, it's a very cool plot device that is very subtle as well.
Does make a difference in storytelling for sure.
Yeah, having that environment. I have a hollow wall here, but at least I get more stone.
No, damn it!
Right when the world saved. Did you get creepered again?
Yes, they're just like bullying me so hard today. God,
what's your level?
21.
Yeah, that would do it. Wouldn't it?
It would do it. Yeah, well, it would.
Yeah.
I think it increases the frequency with which mobs spawn around you the higher the level you get.
Exactly.
Look, all right, I'm just a little annoyed, okay?
Well, can you like dump your experience somewhere and
nope. Oh. There's no banking of experience.
Well, I meant
there's
like in an item, just like get an axe or something and enchant it.
Not until 30, because I wouldn't want to waste the levels, and it only uses 2 or 3 levels anyways.
Oh, yeah.
It used to use all of your levels, but
I should build like a door or something here. That would make sense.
Notice the cell phone. Speaking of cell phone sizes, have you noticed that cell phones kept getting smaller and smaller until they added cameras and people were able to take selfies, and they started getting bigger and bigger again?
Yeah.
It's true. It's true, though. It's crazy to me that that's like a thing that even happens.
Well, yeah. Cameras. I mean, the cool thing about cell phones is that they replace all traditional parts of a computer that most people really need, like a camera and a recorder and like a voice recorder and, you know, basic calculator and stuff like that. Like, you don't really need to carry around that stuff anymore because your phone is your multi-tool.
Right. Shout out to Cute Kitty Chick. How's it going? I'm Beam. Good to see you.
Cute
but
Kitty
yeah,
Chick.
It's
my
yeah,
wife would love you.
Too.
She loves cute kitties.
He gets. Meow, meow, meow. All right. Formal always liked big phones. I like big phones and I cannot lie.
Oh boy. So wait, the portal leads to the same place? I thought when you made a new portal it opened at a different area.
It's based on chunks now, I think. So they will share spawn spots unless you make it really far away.
Oh, that sucks. Well, I have a fast way back to the to home now, I guess.
There you go.
I was hoping to like.
That's why they did it, I think, is so that you can make quicker ways to get.
Yeah.
Like have child portals or whatever. So.
Yeah, but I can't get like back to my tower through that. That sucks.
Right.
I have to walk back again. Oh well.
All right, come on.
It's cool.
Grab some of these. I need to grab more. Coal soon.
More of this up.
I'm gonna be using a lot of coal for this.
Well, we have a lot of it available, so you can go hog wild.
I plan on it.
So you got anything going on this weekend?
I have to work a little bit tomorrow. Work has been pretty brutal lately, but I can't complain too much because it's a steady paycheck. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I actually have to do a little bit of work after we finish recording these MSIS episodes.
Oh.
Not much, but a little bit. Like yeah. Maybe 20 minutes worth, but still a pain.
Yeah, can't I complain. Hear you.
Yeah, just tired. I'm just tired, I think, is all. I wanna put out like really good stream content and do a quality stream experience, and it's hard to do when you're exhausted.
Yeah,
all the time.
And like, unfortunately, the past couple weeks that we've done this, like, I think we've both been so busy that
yes.
we both kind of come into this half. I was gonna say half in the bag, but that's not exactly true. Just
tired
half awake.
Hell.
Yeah,
yeah.
And that's not a bad thing. Like, I still like this show to be something that we just hang out and chat. And
I look forward to it every week.
Yeah,
it's
a good way to unwind, but. Sometimes I feel like we're not exactly on our game as we are some other weeks, but I think that's just how it goes.
I think it's just going to be a thing because we do it at the end of the week. We don't do it on a weekend day for specific reasons.
Yeah.
Furball says F grown-up stuff. F grown-up shit. That's awesome. It's true, though.
If
I
only.
Agree. If only, yeah. I wish I could just tell it to go away. Okay. Let's see. Let me clear out the rest of this.
At some point, could you turn off the spawn zone like lock so we can clean up this area?
I know, I keep forgetting I have to do that in the actual server config.
Oh, okay.
So I have to shut the server down, make
oh
the
my
change,
God.
And then bring it back up. And I'm too lazy to go into the UI.
Yeah, I don't
the panel you. That of my host. Yeah, I'm a lazy.
It's no, it's not a huge deal. It's just one of those things where I keep looking at it. And I'm like, oh my God, no biggie. But yeah, that's why I'm hoping that Color Jumper sells a million units so I can just retire and then I can do this stuff all I want.
Hey man, that's solid, dude.
That's my
Color Jumper's a good game.
Thank you. A lot of people have said that. It's just getting the word out there, I guess.
Yep. Well, so. that's one of the challenges for any game, right?
Yeah.
But your premise is pretty solid. Like the tough as nails platformer is not a frequent thing. Like it really isn't.
Well, it's attempted a lot. I mean,
it is.
There's a lot of speedrun games out there. Like, I want to be the guy.
Fuck Color Jumper. That's how I felt. If anybody has seen my salt mine videos on YouTube, oh man, you seem to enjoy it a little bit, Ben.
Oh yeah, no, seriously.
Suffering.
I did not know how much enjoyment I could get out of human suffering until I watched you play the game. So that was nice. That was a nice little revelation for me.
Hey, my video series on it has come along pretty well, too, if I do say so myself. I'm really enjoying it.
Did you release the second?
My rage is... No, that's going to be next week. I think next Wednesday.
Gotcha.
I have right now... I have to export it. I need to add the end, the outro video bit highlight. But yeah, I did Deus Ex Mankind Divided's first episode, which comes out Monday, and then I didn't want to put them too close together, so I did my second Salt Mine episode Wednesday.
That makes sense. So,
Formal says right in the square hole.
Well, I appreciate you playing it. Like I was really surprised when I saw so many people like trying it and just doing a let's play of it. Because I posted it on Reddit's like our let's play or whatever, and I was expecting like one or two people, but I think I got like 10 or so. Like I have a list of bookmarks that I have of all the let's plays, and I try to pimp their channels whenever I remember, which is not often enough. Just trying to, you know, try to help give back a little bit to the people who helped get the word out there. But yeah, I don't know. Like I have high hopes for the game, but I also don't want to get my hopes up because I know that just leads to disappointment sometimes. So I'm kind of 50-50.
Yeah, well, just enjoy it for what it is. And
yeah.
You've gotten some really good positive feedback out of it, and I think that's well worth the effort.
Yeah.
In my view anyways, cuz you'll be able to take so much new knowledge from that, like how you know, people react to a game and, you know, the way to market yourself and all that stuff. That's super valuable to have. So
Yeah, and that's
either
something.
Way, you can look at it as a win, I think. At least from my perspective, I'm not in your shoes, so I can't.
Oh no, it's cool. I feel the same way. I mean, I think we talked about this a little bit when Shaka was on the stream as well, where like finishing a project is as much as important as a skill as anything else when it comes to the creation process. So just knowing, did you just turn it to day again?
Maybe. Okay. I don't want to fight zombies out here.
Because I'm trying to find skeletons so I can get bones. That's no big deal though. We have a bunch of bone meal in the town hall. But yeah, I mean, like, finishing a project is super important, and that's kind of what you've been doing with your whole Let's Play stuff. Just learning the process of making and releasing a Let's Play video is very different from just like recording something and posting it online like we do with these videos. So.
Well, and it's nice because editing my stream videos into Let's Plays, it has actually shown me the flaws I have in my stream in terms of like video quality or sound quality.
Oh.
And makes me really want to improve that. So I've been working on that, and I think my sound quality's already improved a little bit. I got a new green screen, which isn't perfect yet, but it's getting there. Mm-hmm. But I got a new green screen that absorbs some of the sound that was bouncing off the wall behind me, and I think I'm a little less echoey than I was.
I don't hear much of an echo, if that helps.
Yeah, and it used to be a little, like, I used to sound, like, hollow almost because it would bounce off the wall behind me, and it would really pick up that reverberation a little bit, and I think it's better because from what I can hear in my headphones, it's improved a little bit.
Yeah, I think
that's
it's better.
Well said. So, I think it's improved a little bit too, and it's amazing because I just took your advice and it was like, well, hang something on the wall, and I just put my new green screen up, and it seems to help.
Is that like a sheet then? Well, not like a sheet, but is it actually a cloth?
It's just like a bed sheet. It's like the same kind of like material. It's not like a comforter, but it's like a bed sheet. Not a fitted or anything, but we have it folded in half and hanging on the wall behind me on 3M command strips, hooks. And so it kind of sits on the wall, but it also is a little away from the wall.
Yeah,
and there's an air pocket
separation
in between the folds.
And that's really
important.
And
I think that helps a lot.
That's
super
important for sound dampening.
Yeah, so with any luck, that'll help. And I'm going to put more stuff on the walls in here, which may help as well. But it seems to have improved already, the quality, at least from my headphone perspective.
Well, that's good to hear. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. it's taking forever. Well, we're almost up at an hour for this stream. But I'm just finishing up one of my many staircases that I have to do.
Okay. Well, give me just a second here.
It's no rush.
Soup. Soup just popped into my chat.
Hey, Soup. There's Soup and Soap, and I get them confused all the time. Because they have names that sound very similar phonetically. There we go. So, yeah, we can work on closing up this episode, and we can move on to the next game for the Sunday episode. And, as always, I apologize if I've been a little low energy today, but having a headache and just generally being a lazy bum will do that to you, I guess. I made a door float. I didn't know I could do that.
That's interesting. So, okay, so sorry about that. I had to count.
I was just talking
because there's dead air. It's fine. I actually am looking forward to doing my video editing now, which is really cool. So
that's a nice
change
of pace.
It's a really good creative outlet. Like before, I was like, I don't want to because I'm not good at it and all this stuff. And I was just like, you know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna do it, and I did it, and it's really worthwhile. It's actually very fulfilling.
That's good. I mean, that's the best way to do it too. Like just learning it and then just being very happy with how it turned out.
Yep. And I mean, I got a lot of improvement to do, but I am happy with it so far. Okay, I am inside the house.
Okay, I'm gonna head back there once I build this door, and we can wrap this up. So how about this? How about Tim, you tell us where we can find you online, and I'll start making my way back home.
Okay, well, you can find myself at on Twitch, which my lovely chat is hanging out in right now. You can find me on Twitch at twitch.tv/insertcointheater. I'm also on Beam, which is beam.pro/insertcointheater. Thank you, Beam folks, for hanging out with me as well. You guys are awesome. I know I'm still new to the platform, but it's exciting to see some new faces popping through there. I also can be found on YouTube at youtube.com/insertcointheater.com. That's insertcointheater, DOTCOM. I know I said fast, but and then you can find me on the web at insert.
I gotta get back to the sauna.
Find me online at insertcointheater.com, and oh, I gotta get to the sauna too. I'm gonna ruin the whole
sploosh
thing.
Yep, you ruined it.
But also, I hopped off the thing, and then also you can find me on Twitter at twitter.com/insertcointim. What about you, Mr. Ben Burns? Where can they locate you on the webs?
Eat doors. You can find me online at Ben_Burns. That's B-U-R-N-E-S at Twitch, Twitter, Patreon, and YouTube. And I primarily do music stuff, but I have been doing more gaming stuff lately. And something I'll message for something I'll talk about in the next episode is I can talk about the extended play.
Sweet! So, whoa, I like geez. That. All right. Well, we should probably.
Well. But yeah, that was just very loud. Sometimes your compressor doesn't always catch up. so yeah, I guess that's where I lost my train of thought. Somebody showed up in my Twitch chat. Hi, Lord of Hellfire. Thanks for showing up on Twitch. We'll end this episode right here. And we are going
to switch over to
a different game. Orcs Must Die!
Oh, yeah. Orcs Must Die 2. But stick around because we're still going to be in chat and stuff, so we're not stopping stream, we're just stopping the recording. So
yep.
To those of you watching on YouTube, thank you so much.
Yep. See you later.